So in today's Catholic and Fit series, we're talking about what it means to move well. This is in the continuum phase, live a movement lifestyle. It's one of the things we focus on in Catholic Fit. We always remember James chapter 2, verse 17 says that faith without works is dead. In Catholic Fit, we also say fitness without movement is the same. So we ask, what does it mean to be Catholic? What does it mean to be fit? Those are the two questions that drive us in Catholic Fit. And so what does it mean to be fit? Well, you need to move more. We know we should be going for a walk in order to burn calories or increase our cardiovascular health. But we don't always slow down and think about what does it mean to move well. We should be moving well and then moving often. But today is all about moving well using a theory or an approach called the joint-by-joint approach. I've been posting some of the daily videos, daily workout videos, and I'm not always sure who's watching the videos. You could be a 30-year-old athlete who's playing recreational basketball. You could be a 45-year-old mother of three who is staying active as much as possible. You could be a 65-year-old grandma who's picking up her grandchild for the first time and thinking about, wow, how does your lower back feel when you pick up your grandchild? That's what we mean by moving well. How well do you do these movements? How well do you walk the steps, get up from a chair? How well do you get down on the floor and back up? No matter your fitness level or your fitness goals, these things are important. God built inside of us this incredible ability to move well. If you think about a weightlifter picking up a heavy weight, like a heavy barbell, or you think about a grandmother picking up her grandchild, 75 years old, bending over, picking up a 30-pound baby, right? That's what we call a deadlift. That's what we call a pickup, okay, if you will. And we coach that. I have personal training clients and that I teach movement to, and we go over those. We get stronger with that movement. How do you pick up a kettlebell or a dumbbell or a bag of mulch or a heavy bucket of rocks? And I can coach people and train people to do that better. But the awesome thing about the human body that God blessed us with is that if you watch a 2-year-old who's just walking, you know, for about a year of his or her life, if you roll a soccer ball up to that toddler, they will squat down and pick up that soccer ball perfectly with perfect form and stand up straight. And they were never coached. They never read a book about what it means to deadlift or anything like that, but they just do this naturally. We have this natural ability to move well, but we lose that throughout our years because we're sitting too much, we're sitting at desk chairs too much. From the time we're in preschool or kindergarten, we're sitting at a desk, and that can continue through a lifetime if we have a desk job. We lose the ability to move well, and this is one of the reasons we're going to talk about today. And I hope by understanding this, then you can go back to all the daily workouts and the exercise videos that I post, or if you're a teacher or a parent, you can help understand ways to teach your students and your kids ways to move better. And you can see why maybe they can't do some of the exercises you're doing with the rest of your class. Okay? This is what we call the joint-by-joint approach. And what we want to focus on or look at is the ideas of mobility and stability. Now, we think of the words strength and flexibility in fitness. Some people say I'm very flexible, some people are very strong, and sometimes we picture the strong person as being sort of stiff, not very flexible, but very strong. While another person can do the splits and touch their toes, and they're very flexible, but they're not very strong, ideally we have a little bit of both. In Catholic Fit, we refer to these words as mobility and stability. They're better words than strength and flexibility. So think of parts of your body as having more mobility. Other parts of your body is having more stability. Now, traditionally, you can look at the pictures here that Becky's doing a hamstring stretch lying on her back. She's working on her flexibility. And the other picture, she's doing a plank. That's a stability exercise. So she's working on either stretching out her hamstrings, or what we look at, if you look at this picture, she's doing a mobility exercise for her left hip joint. Okay, to see how far her left hip joint can move so her thigh comes closer to her chest. And the other exercise is the planking exercise, which is developing stability through her joints. How well can she stabilize her body to hold that plank position, which then carries over to an upright standing position where we then stand with good posture. Okay, so one is a mobility exercise, one is a stability exercise. The joint-by-joint approach says that we have a stack of joints in our body. Think about your ankles, then your knees, and then your hips, and then your vertebrae. This stack of joints has a pattern of a joint having more mobility, like your ankles. You can move your ankles. So take a second and just do a big circle with your ankle joint. So you have all that mobility in your ankle joint. It goes in full circles. You can pull your toes back towards your shin. You can point your toes. That's a lot of mobility in your ankle joint. Your knee, on the other hand, is more of a stable area of your body. You don't have the same mobility in your knee. You can bend it and straighten it. You can flex it and extend it. And there's a little bit of rotation there, but that's more of a stable joint. Then we work up to your hip, and that becomes a more mobile joint. And that's what we're talking about today. So a quick example of mobility and stability in your body is the ankle mobility example. So look at this picture here. If you can see the picture, that's me. That's the picture here. So see how I'm sitting there in a chair. And in the big picture, I have a little bit more of a difficult time. I would have a hard time standing up if I didn't show any ankle mobility here. See how my ankles are about 90 degrees. Maybe this looks like you. You're trying to stand up from a chair. Whether you're lifting a weight or you're just getting it from your chair at home, you really have to lean over more here, and then that can cause an issue with your lower back. Versus this picture, if I can have a little more mobility in my ankle joint, see this, I'm bending, I'm stretching my heel cord, my ankle a little bit more. Now I can get my feet underneath me a little bit more, and then I stand up, and I'm not going to use as much lower back. So the importance of having ankle mobility is important just for standing up from a chair, okay? And that's what these things say here. And again, if you don't understand some of this, but I love teaching these ideas because it's kind of a simple idea. Ankle dorsiflexion is when you pull your foot back towards your shin. So this angle is just a little smaller than this angle here, which is a 90 degree angle, all right, as you see in the skeleton ankle joint here, okay? Why do you lack ankle mobility? Well, it might be because what we say here is that your bones aren't moving well. If you have a little bit of arthritis, those bones just do not move very well together. Or your heel core, your Achilles tendon, that might be stiff. That's why hydration is so important. That's why stretching your ankle joint is so important, because it's a part of your body that you want more mobility. So if you're going to stretch one part of your body every day, your heel cord is a great place to start. If you're my age, and you're running around, tonight I coach my seventh grade girls basketball team. I want to run around with them, demonstrate layups, and run up and down the court with them. A lot of guys my age will blow out their Achilles tendon because they lack the flexibility and they lack the mobility in their ankle joint, and their heel cord gets caught up in the action and can tear, okay? So a couple different reasons you might have some ankle mobility problems. So another slide to look at is, this is sort of the joint by joint approach. That we see that that if we run up and down the skeleton, see the ankle is more mobile, and then the knee is more stable. The hip joint, we want to be more mobile. And then this yellow area here, see the areas of stability? This is your core, this is your pelvis area, right? You want your lumbar spine to be a little more stable. That's why we do core exercises. And then as you move up, you get to your thoracic spine, which is your upper back here. Okay, kind of like this area here, you want that to be more mobile. Now what happens is, if we're sitting a lot at a chair, okay, if you're sitting at a desk chair a lot, maybe you're watching this video, and from the side view, if I'm sitting here like this, you can tend to slouch a little bit, okay? And you can, because you have the mobility, let me increase this a little bit, because you have the mobility in your spine, you may slouch over like this, because you have the mobility in your upper back. Which is good, we need that mobility, it's important, but then it allows us to fall into this poor posture. Your body gets good at what you ask it to do most of the time. So if you're sitting down most of the day, then your body's going to get good at sitting, slouching, and you're gonna lose that mobility. Eventually, your upper back will get stiff, and that compromises your ability to then reach up and do different things. If I lose the mobility here, that's going to affect other joints. And that's the idea of the joint by joint approach. Because of the way our joints are stacked, if we lose ankle mobility here, it's going to affect our knees. Our ankles should be very mobile, a lot of mobility. But if you have stiff ankles, then your knee needs to become more mobile. And that's where you can bother your ACL, you can bother your meniscus, you can have knee pain, Okay? If your hips lack mobility, that mobility is then compensated for in your lumbar spine. And so when you get, if your hips tend to tighten up and stiffen up, then you may end up with lower back pain. So it's not a matter of stretching out your lower back as you may be inclined to do. It's a matter of loosening up your hips. And in Catholic Fit, we do a lot of hip mobility exercises in order to alleviate those other areas where you may feel pain. It's the areas of stability that you end up feeling a lot of the pain, like in your knees and your lower back especially. Okay, so I like to think this is kind of a simple idea, something to think about, but when you do think about, okay, I'm going to do two stretches today with my walk. My goal is to be Catholic and fit. I'm going to start moving. What does that look like? You can go for a walk, be mindful of how you're moving, and then think, okay, what exercises do you do when you return home? I just went for a 20-minute walk around my neighborhood. I'm listening to Father Mike Schmidt's 20-minute podcast episode of A Bible in a Year. It's awesome. That's what my daily workouts are based on. And then you come back and do what? Okay, there goes my 20-minute walk. What stretches am I going to do? You can do a heel cord stretch. Bring your foot up on something. I'll demonstrate this in another video. Just to do a wrist stretch. So my wrist should be a mobile spot so I can go here and pull my hand back. I'm trying to get in the video. There you go. There, and just work on ankle or wrist mobility. If you're typing a lot, if you're sewing a lot, knitting a lot, if you're just doing a lot of mouse work and keyboard work to prevent you from developing carpal tunnel syndrome. So a lot of what we do in Catholic Fit is to honor our natural gifts and then learn physical maintenance techniques for maintaining those physical gifts that we have been blessed with. Okay? So, you know, we hear a lot about taking care of the temple of the Holy Spirit. I want to give you specific strategies from a trusted faith-based standpoint. I love looking at our Catholic faith through the prism of our fitness, but also looking at our personal fitness through the lens of our Catholic faith. And that's what we're doing in Catholic Fit. So please comment below. Let me know what your acre pain is, or maybe where you have mobility issues in one of these things listed here. I left this slide up, right? So if your ankle is pretty tight, act like your big toe is a pencil and draw a big circle with your big toe and pay attention to your ankle joint and see, can you draw a pretty clean big circle, or is there a part of that circle that you're sort of missing? Is there a corner that you're missing? So draw a big counterclockwise circle and a big clockwise circle with your ankle and just test the mobility. That's a good exercise to do every day. And then in other Catholic videos, we'll go through a number of exercises to improve your ankle mobility. My brother-in-law the other day, he stepped up on some steps, and I'm sure it was something, either his hip or his ankle did not mobilize the way that it should have, and his knee ended up tweaking, okay? And then he fell again about a week later trying to avoid landing on his daughter, and he blew out his ACL. But I believe that first one was a weird way that he stepped onto the step to where his hip and ankle did not mobilize. He did not express the mobility required to stabilize his knee. His knee became more mobile. Those joints moved, and he blew out his ACL. No fun at all. So that's what we want to work on in Catholic Fit. So thank you for checking this out. If you have any comments below, I want to know who's watching some of these videos so I understand how best to base these videos. But this is an important concept. I use this for training all of my athletes. For training all of my clients, whether I meet with a 15-year-old volleyball player who wants to come and increase her vertical jump, or a 78-year-old grandma who wants to just work outside in their backyard and take care of her grandchildren, this is an important thing to understand, mobility and stability in your body. Check out my other videos. We're doing a daily workout, 20-minute workouts, to either a podcast episode of A Year in the Bible with Father Mike Schmitz, or just to keep moving. Okay, so keep moving. God bless you. God bless all those people out there who cannot move, who cannot exercise today because they're sick or injured. If you're having a hard time being motivated and exercising for yourself, exercise for them. See how you feel after that. God bless you, and I'll see you next time. Oh, I won't see you next time. I want to show you this next slide. I just had this slide up. You know, we're moving in either prayer or play, right? So we'll go through a genuflect and understand what a genuflect means, but whether you are praying, whether you are playing golf, movement is so important. We want to maintain that. I want to save the genuflect. I want to see people genuflecting more in church. All right. Now I'll leave you alone. Thank you so much. God bless.